all of my many friends, also to my many enemies. Once again, it's your friend, brother, and humble servant, Roosevelt, coming back at you with another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. I'd like to thank everyone, and I do mean everyone, for tuning into the program on today. And if you're not yet a subscriber to Roosevelt Sounds Off, please go down and hit that subscribe button along with the bell icon. This way you'll be notified anytime I drop a brand new video right here on YouTube. Oh yes, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it has been a long time since I got an opportunity to do a video. You know, certain things been going on in my life that's kept me busy and everything, and you know, just haven't had time to come to you. But now I am back. I haven't gone any place. So please, somebody tell somebody what I am trying to outline here on YouTube, and also urge them to subscribe. And if you just happen to just come across this channel by any video that I have made, only thing I have to say is subscribe, 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 and share. Okay, gonna get right into what I want to talk about on today. And this is a little bit of news. This, I'm gonna bring you a clip, but I'm gonna set the stage for you a little bit. First of all, this particular incident that we're gonna cover today comes from my home, which is Chicago, Illinois, but not necessarily in Chicago proper, but in one of our suburbs called Riverdale. For all of y'all who don't live here, Riverdale just happens to be a south suburb right outside of the Chicago area, around like the southwest side, you know, kind of like in the hundreds and like around the 141st. And, you know, it's a whole bunch of clusters of suburbs and little towns that are right over there. You have Riverdale, then there's Dalton, and Harvey is a little bit more further towards the south. And then towards the east, you have South Holland. And if you go a little bit much more east, then you have Calumet City. And if you go any more east, especially if you go over State Line Road on Sibley, then you're crossing the Indiana-Illinois border into Hammond, Indiana. So that's just like a little bit of a makeup for all of y'all who don't know. But this story is coming from Riverdale, Illinois. And this involves a young man named Devontae Scott. And he was tased by a Riverdale police officer. And the reason why this made the news is because he is now suing the Riverdale Police Department for being unjustly tased while he was in his girlfriend's apartment. I guess the story goes is that the girlfriend wanted him to leave, so he's asleep. And then there's this officer who comes in and starts yelling at him. You're gonna hear the clip. And the thing is, even though the officer is not shown, you can definitely tell this is the voice of a black police officer. Oh yes, for all of you, you know, people out there who want to just raise your head and strut around and stroke your beard and act like that we're so much better, or the black community is so much better with black police officers than white police officers. Seeing this, I got a heck of a debate for you. So I'm not going to waste any more time. I'm going to go ahead and play you this clip. And this clip comes to us compliments of Channel 9 News here in Chicago, WGN. And I'm going to come right back and tell you exactly what I think. And for all you all who know me personally and have been watching me for a while, I am Roosevelt, and I will not hold back. Please stay tuned for this clip.
Well, there is a new lawsuit against the village of Riverdale and two of its police officers. They're accused of using excessive force against a man in his home.
The video in this story may be disturbing for some viewers. Let's go to WGN's Jewel Hillary. She's got more.
Hi, good evening, you all. The 28-year-old man you're about to see in the following video says a police officer unjustly shot him with a stun gun multiple times. The man's attorney says that wasn't necessary because his client did not pose an imminent or immediate threat to officers.
Excuse me, young man.
I just wish this stuff would stop.
On November 11th, 2021, 28-year-old Devontae Scott says he was asleep when a village of Riverdale police officer angrily and abruptly woke him up. The encounter all caught on officer's body-worn cam.
Young man, Young man!
A male and female officer were called to Scott's apartment because his girlfriend at the time allegedly wanted him out.
Boy, if you don't show me your hands!
Scott and the officer go back and forth, and the male officer pulls out his stun gun and shoots Scott.
Show me your hands, boy! Show me your hands!
He was under arrest, wasn't being detained.
Scott's attorney, Nate Bernard, who we met in Bensonville, filed a lawsuit against the Village of Riverdale and the two officers involved, claiming a number of allegations, including excessive force against the male officer.
After the second taser, my client fell off of the bed, screaming in agony on the ground, and the officer delivered a third taser to him while he was on the ground.
What is heard about that?
Scott says the pain was excruciating.
It's like your body is just in a daze where it feel like it's paralyzed. That was a situation that if it wasn't his taser, it could have been his real gun.
Bernard claims the second officer involved failed to intervene.
The law states that when a constitutional violation is occurring, that officer has an obligation to intervene and to stop that constitutional violation from happening. She sat back in silence and did nothing.
At the time, Scott was arrested and charged with resisting or obstructing a peace officer, a charge Bernard says isn't valid.
The law is very clear that in order for someone to be charged with resisting or obstructing, there needs to be some physical manifestations.
Scott's girlfriend at the time was also arrested and charged with disorderly conduct for filing a false police report. We have reached out to the Village of Riverdale for a comment, but we have not heard back. Reporting in Bensonville, I'm Jewel Hillary, WGN News.
Okay, and we are back. And of course, that particular clip is compliments of the WGN Channel 9 News, located here in the great city of Chicago, Illinois, and that particular clip falls under the category of fair use. So let's get ready to get into this. First of all, you had this man, like I said, Dante Scott, in his girlfriend's apartment because she wanted him out. So, you know, I think that's the worst thing that we could do, is sometimes always want to find a reason to call the police. Because police departments, whether they be Black or whether they be white, whether they be Asian or Hispanic, Black people, we got to just openly admit that the cavalry is not arriving. Police are not here to help us. If anything, they're here to harm us much more than anything. I mean, look at the cases of George Floyd or Tatiana Jefferson or Breonna Taylor or Michael Brown and Jamar Clark and Stephon Clark, Philando Castillo, Eric Garner, Sandra Bland, and the list just goes on and on and on and on. And you hear in the background the voice of this officer, who's a Black police officer, which goes to show you that what I have to always say about Black police officers is true, that Black police officers are always much more aggressive than white officers. Yeah, he's talking, young man, young man, young man. Dude, who do you think you're talking to? And then starts to tase him. If you don't let me see your hands, then all of a sudden just starts tasing him, which is a lethal form of force. Mr. Scott was not under arrest. He got woke up out of a sleep and started getting yelled at. And getting tased, and he is unarmed. Talking about, what's hard about that? Black officers treat us worse than white police officers do. Because I guess, you know, as long as somebody became a Black police officer, I guess in a Black police officer's mind, they think that they're above all the rest of the Negroes in the Black community. They think for some reason that they have arrived. They think, as long as I have the imaginary little power of the badge and the gun, then I could treat other Black people like they're the enemy and like
they're my doormat, and I can just walk over them and do whatever it is that I want to do. This is the mind and the thinking of the black police officer. But yet you have a whole lot of people out there talking about that. Well, you know, and I've had some even tell me, well, Roosevelt, it, you know, we need more black officers in the black community, because if I'm ever in trouble, then I want to see another brother or another sister who look just like me. But wait a minute. What if this other brother or sister who looks just like you will treat you worse than the other group of people will do? And also, not only that, police officers are always considered to be a gang. They cover each other's wrong up, because there's a female officer who is with this other officer, and she's seeing all of this stuff take place. Mr. Scott's rights being violated, Mr. Scott being tased unjustly when he's unarmed, and she's just sitting back, not saying one mumbling word. She's like Jesus when he was going to the cross. You know how they said when Jesus was going to the cross, he was walking up Golgotha, and he was carrying the cross, and he wasn't saying or uttering one mumbling word. That's how she was acting. But the behavior of these officers is far from the behavior of Jesus. Because they could see one of their people do something wrong, and they will not correct, and they will not stop this other officer from threatening someone else's life or rights. Because if I'm a police officer, if I have a partner with me who's going too far, who is getting ready to rough up a person or getting ready to beat up a person, I would stand in the middle of this person and this other officer, and I would face the officer, and I would say, look, man, stop. If you don't stop, then I'm going to arrest you. If he kept on going, I would find a way that I could turn him around or flip him around or knock him on the ground, and I would take his gun and his badge from him, and I would be putting that other officer in handcuffs. Why? Because as a police officer, you took an oath to uphold the, first of all, to defend and protect the Constitution of the United States of America, but also to defend the rights of the citizens that you are protecting and policing. You never took an oath to one another. It's because it's not about you. It's about the community. This is why black people as a whole don't have a trust for police or policing within this country. Because many officers, and yet they always try to say that there's good police officers out there. But how can you be a good police officer whenever you're quote unquote a good police officer, but yet you see another one doing wrong and you're not standing in the gap to try to stop the injustice or the wrongdoing that is happening? You can never ever say that you are good unless you stop injustice and violation of rights and even killing of people and the citizens of this country if you don't stand in the gap and do something about it. It took so long for this story to come to light because I guess that, first of all, you know, the legal process is like a long process. Well, first of all, before he could really do anything, he had to first of all clear the, criminal complaint, and those charges were dropped. But then, you know, you have to file a civil complaint, And we haven't heard the last of this, because a whole lot of people know that whenever these things are going through the courts, that these kind of cases could take years. So he has filed a lawsuit against these officers and against the village of Riverdale, which he should, which I do hope that he wins. And if it were up to me, these two officers, for their brutality and for their incompetence, would be fired. We do not need police officers like this in the village of Riverdale, in Harvey, South Holland, Calumet City, Hammond, Calumet Park, or Chicago, or anywhere for that matter. Officers who are gonna brutalize people and unjustly tase unarmed citizens and violate people's rights. We don't need people like that. So with all of that being said, I do hope that there is some justice for Mr. Scott and that he does win this lawsuit against the village of Riverdale. So if I end up hearing anything, you know me, I'm always going to try my best to keep my ear to the ground, and I'll always report back to you anything that I have heard. But until then, I believe this is where I'm going to end and leave this video. I think it's enough that has been said. So at this point, if anybody liked this video, please do me a favor, give me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. And please tune in next time for another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. And until the next video, this has been your friend, brother, and humble servant Roosevelt, saying peace and blessings to all of you and your families.